This is Seibert signing in to Generals Zero Hour on the map, Make 2, where we get to watch a couple of guys guarding some goals. And I mean, that might be the most exciting thing that happens all game. I, of course, kid, because on the left side, as the purple China, we have X-Cal, just regular old vanilla China. And on the right side, just barely selling off his pink infantry general command center, this is Hockey. Apparently, going for a war factory there. I don't know that this is Hockey, but I think this is Hockey. Slow VE3. Yeah, whatever. Double war factory opening up for Hockey, and right into the airfield for X-Cal. Now, before this game gets too underway, by the way, I'm not super familiar with this map. I did have a quick look around, but this is not Tournament Desert, so I don't know what's going on. Anyways, I mean, it's General Zero Hour. I don't know what's going on anyways. In the description, there is a link to a thread, which may still be active, where you can ask some questions of me for a game replays interview. If that is your jam and you want to ask me a question for the interview, go ahead and do that at the link in the description. I mean, you can ask me a question in the comments, but it's more fun if you participate in the interview format. So if you're interested in a little interview question, I will answer that. Or actually, I don't know, maybe the guy who's doing the interview will sort through those questions and he'll just choose some questions. I don't know how it's going to happen. But anyways, in the south, Oil Derrick going to be getting grabbed up by X-Cal. And what a helpful tooltip that is. But if you didn't know, now you know. I think that was a Dragon tank getting cleaned up by a MiG as X-Cal clears the ground. By the way, I have not been casting any Zero Hour for quite some time because I had this really fun Zero Hour bug where Zero Hour would just stutter every like 10 to 20 seconds. A couple of rocket hunters, tank hunters going to be jumping out of the listening outposts. They do get smashed there as the MiGs clean up basically everything. And, well, I guess this rocket trooper inside of that building cleaned up the other listening outpost. And, well, the MiGs might be a little bit overkill, but X-Cal once again cleans up everything that Hockey has in that little assault. The Dragon tank, all the listening outposts, all the rocket squads as well. Also going to be cleaning up an additional listening outpost. X-Cal getting some good use out of those MiGs for sure. The fast airfield definitely paying off in this case. He's done very well with his defense. That's a second airfield going on up here in the north. By the way, this is a 3-supply, pretty quick. I don't know, is 3.5 minutes slow for or normal speed for 3-supply? That feels faster, but maybe that's just because of Tournament Desert kind of stuff where it's 2-supply, and then you get the supplies in the middle. But by the way, there are a couple of supply caches here kind of in the middle of the map in kind of a north and a southern split. Another Dragon tank and another listening outpost, but once again, the MiGs come in, I think completely escaping unscathed from these attacks in almost every case. And one minigunner going to be able to take down the rest of these tank hunters, and well, goodbye, tank hunters. I guess having that defensive turret may be useful after all. In the south, Dragon tank going to be cleaning up the oil derrick. So X-Cal loses the oil derrick, and it looks like, this is a dozer actually up here. Eventually, Hockey may capture his own oil derrick, but not for now. But yeah, 3.5 minutes felt fast for third supply. Maybe it's not. Dragon tank from X-Cal going to be getting cleaned up by Hockey. He's got the, whatever the APC is called, Assault Troop Transport, because of course it comes loaded with minigunners. Is there a cat sound effect? I swear there's a cat sound effect. Like, somewhere in the middle of the map, I keep hearing a cat yowl, which is maybe not the best, like, ambient sound effect to include in your map. But it's kind of funny that they even have that in Zero Hour. And Dragon Tank for X-Cal going to be, well, getting cleaned up, as it turns out. The defensive turret, actually pretty useful for both players, apparently. Both of them capturing that, and I mean, I would have assumed that those go uncaptured, but again, I don't watch a lot of Zero Hour. Hoping to change that in the near future. Of course, I did reinstall Zero Hour so I could hopefully get everything running smoothly. And so far, it seems to be doing well. Dragon Tank once again going to be stepping forward. Listening outposts are going to be able to shut that down. And both listening outposts do escape. So Hockey is, well, he won't necessarily... Actually, the ECM tank almost saving that assault troop transport. But nope. Nothing gets saved in the end. The firewall from this dragon tank going to be helping out those MiGs in creating a firestorm to just lock everything down and burn everything up. And this minigunner walking through the wall of flame to be the hero that Hockey needs as he cleans up that dragon tank. Of course, I mean, it's a dragon tank shut down, so it's not like it's much of a threat anyways. In the north... Two dragon tanks, maybe? I'm not sure what that was, but Xcal stepping forward with a little bit of an attack, and again, getting nowhere. Hockey's defense a little bit too good, but at the same time, Xcal, with his double airfield, a million MiGs kind of production that he's got going on here, which I love that he's keeping these MiGs in the air at pretty much all times. They are so ready to go, but both of these guys playing well enough defensively. They're not letting anything slip by. There's none of this, like, sneaky one dragon tank, two dragon tanks, or, like, small assaults that would sometimes slip by, especially against a lesser player. But in this case, they're both playing well enough and aware enough defensively that just nothing is getting by them. Although this dragon tank from Xcal, another like two dragon tank hit squad, heading out to the right side of the map, cleans up a dozer, and it looks like Black Lotus out on the field going to be locking down one dragon tank, and the second one will most likely get eliminated by this little combination force, but the MiGs clean everything up. Once again, Xcal with his MiGs, the hammer that they are, just smashing everything that Hockey tries, just smashing it to pieces. In the south, supply going up, although in the north, it looks like it's already up and running for Xcal. Going to be dropping a bunker as well for a little bit of defense. And Hockey, with the first kind of big assault of the game, rolling out in the south. Going to be going after the bunker, and an ECM tank steps forward, but it gets locked down by Hockey. Xcal is going to need a little bit more for defense. Looks like the MiGs are about to swoop in, and the Firestorm may be enough to lock everything down, but no, one listening outpost is surviving. Two ECM tanks barely surviving, which means their dragon tanks that Xcal is sending aren't doing much of anything. The listening outpost stepping forward, and once again, a hero multi-gunner, mini-gunner rather, going to be coming forward for Hockey to get a couple of kills. He's thinking of his friend earlier who was killing off that dragon tank in the first couple of minutes of this match. And he himself, while an Inferno Cannon watches on by Xcal, he's just going to be watching this happen. And actually, a building getting captured down here in the bottom left-hand corner. Hockey going to be stealing the defensive tower away from Xcal. And once again, this minigunner turret still not being stopped by anything that Xcal has. He's actually going to be helping to finish off another dragon tank. That one minigunner doing all of the damage, shutting down this fourth, or what is this? Is this like a 3.5? I guess these are like fully saturated. They just don't last as long. MiG coming in and clearing up absolutely everything as Xcal once again shuts down Hockey. He took a little bit of damage here, and it looks like he's also burning down that defensive tower, so... Inferno Cannons, Gatling Tanks, and Tank Hunters, a pretty good combination for cleaning up those neutral base or those neutral map structures. War Factory right on the front line, so this is a pretty serious defense of this supply post. As, well, actually, it looks like we got a couple of hackers in the bottom right-hand corner flashing away on the mini-map. Going to be kind of revealing themselves, at least to us as observers, as something sneaky going on. Minigunners stepping out and trying to close the distance, and, I mean, not doing really much of anything. I guess they are doing a little bit, and one ECM tank from Hockey getting up close and personal. Last multi, Minigunner does finally go down. If Hockey could close the distance, he probably could clean up this army quite quickly, but... He can't close the distance, and with three ECM tanks right there on the front line, the Inferno Cannons also, I mean, they eat away at everything that Hockey has very quickly once the ECM tanks shut it down, but if hockey could ever close the distance. Migs going to be coming in. This is a huge clump of ECM Infernos and Gatlings, and most of it gets cleaned up. A couple of ECMs going to be surviving, Gatlings as well, so there is still a lot of firepower left in this army, but pretty much all of the Infernos got wiped out by that one swoop of the Migs. They come in, they burn everything down, and it looks like in the north, the third/fourth supply kind of location for hockey has been taken. Xcal is back up and running in the south. Carpet bombing coming in, cleans up a couple of Gatling tanks, but not a big deal, as listening outposts, mini gunners, an assault troop transport. ECM tank lagging behind, but of course it's against Gatling, so it's not the end of the world. Nice split of the Migs, cleans up most of the vehicles that hockey has. Gatling step forward, but then they step back, not wanting to actually directly engage the remainder of hockey's forces, calling in an artillery barrage, and I think it's either going to be a little bit late or it's just going to be going for this structure, and yeah, it's just going to be a little bit late as impacts literally nothing. Mine drop directly on top of this army, cleans up, I guess, just one assault troop transport. I mean, you can get some minigunners inside of it as well, but most of the ECM tanks, the listening outpost, everything else pretty much did escape. And both of these guys, having given up on their sneaky tactics in the north, just focusing much more on the war in the south, trying to make use of, I guess, this mine drop opportunity as Xcal steps forward. The MiGs about to swoop in again as, once again, the ECMs lock down the front line. The MiGs swoop in and clean up the mid-range vehicles, and Xcal, with a 1-2 punch, may be ready to finally knock down this expansion. He's not moving forward just yet. Gatling tanks are pretty battered and bruised right here on the front line. I guess that's actually an ECM tank, not a Gatling. But now that the Infernos are in range, let's see if the MiGs can clean everything up. And the answer is kind of. The Infernos are still here, and they can mount a successful defense, but the War Factory burns down, so the reinforcements are going to be a little bit further away for hockey. ECM getting a lockdown on that assault troop transport gives the Infernos just enough time to burn down every single minigunner as a last ditch. What is this listening outpost even doing? I mean, he is... Oh, actually, no, he didn't get the kill on the Gatling tank. Xcal driving his own Gatling tanks into the firestorm and losing a couple of them. Actually ended up kind of finishing the job for those listening outposts that got cleaned up. And Hockey steps forward, gets the kill on three Inferno cannons. And I think that was a bit of a misstep by Xcal. A little bit wasteful. The MiGs swoop in once again for Xcal. Always there to just finish the job and to clean up almost everything. Black Lotus standing by for Xcal, but not participating in this particular engagement. I guess the propaganda tower here for Xcal was a good idea. He is going to be holding that position for just a moment longer. Dragon tanks and Inferno cannons stepping forward, but it's going to be more listening outposts. Always the response from Hockey. Great flame wall going to be set up here. Should be able to burn down this expansion, and after all of the supply trucks are already gone, so there's no real value to be saved there for Hockey. He loses everything. And Xcal should be able to hold this line. So yeah, the listening outposts not able to make any more progress, and they're not able to head any further forward. Three more hackers up there in the north. These little groups of hackers. Oh, all of these guys, well, half of them are working, the other half not quite working just yet. But Hockey, with all this spread of hackers, I'm sure Xcal has the same thing going on. Nice spread of the MiGs as a carpet bomb comes down, but it misses mostly. It catches an ECM tank and maybe a listening outpost. But the MiGs cleaning up a big chunk of Hockey's army. Hockey coming in once again. The MiGs just doing so much splash damage to the very light armor of both of these armies. Battlemasters finally being mixed in here for Xcal. I genuinely didn't think we'd see Battlemasters. I guess if you're tank general, but I feel like, you know, you don't see them that much with vanilla or infantry general. Dragon tank steps forward, gets a kill on most of the hackers in that little group, all of them going down there as a couple of listening outposts and an assault troop transport going to try and hold the line. ECMs locking down one Battlemaster as they spread and just the missiles spread apart and kill everything else, actually. So Hockey completely shutting down this attack. Xcal just gets eviscerated there as he makes the smallest amount of headway into Hockey's territory before getting completely shut down. I love that Xcal is stealing Hockey's resources. Long-distance mining, or long-distance resource collecting, I guess. Supply collecting? Whatever you call it here in Zero Hour. As the Dragon Tank's once again going to be forming a bit of a firewall. Xcal pulling in the artillery, going to be shelling the expansion of Hockey, and he will catch the dozer. Not actually, the dozer survives, so we can reestablish that supply relatively quickly. Another mine drop coming in. It does get shut down, whatever it was, but the Gatling tank's going to be able to eat up a lot of these minigunners and the rocket troopers, although they jump inside of the listening outpost, and with some nice control, yeah, he does get the cleanup on a couple of the dragon tanks. No, he did get both of the dragon tanks eventually, and the Gatlings with the help of the ECM. That listening outpost barely surviving there, just barely getting the kill on all of that stuff. And a return artillery barrage coming out from Hockey. Oh, he's going for the oil derrick, the secure kill there. By the way, the first nuke 40 seconds away for Xcal. So he's got the three nukes on the way. That's where his cache has been going. Once again, cleaning up Hockey in the middle of the map. And Hockey, with the 40 or the 30 seconds left on the first nuke, needs to make sure that he has something going on, because otherwise he's about to get battered by nukes one after the other if he's not actually able to do anything to stop it. And at this point, he doesn't have much of an army to break through. But Xcal doesn't necessarily have a tough army to stop Hockey. So a couple of MiG strikes could be enough to hold Xcal off, and Hockey might be able to do some real damage with just a couple of units supported by those MiGs. First nuke, ready to go. MiGs coming in for Xcal, cleaning up absolutely everything. That two-unit hit squad, I mean, not counting the million infantry that are inside of it. Nuke fires off, and I have no idea where it's even going to impact. Gets over here. I don't know, this was Propaganda Center, War Factory, something was up here as he cleans up that little chunk of the map. The texture on that hill looks so funky with all the radiation below it. Once again, capturing these defensive towers, these artillery platforms, is absolutely hilarious by Hockey as he steps forward with a couple of assault helicopters, but they all get cleaned up. No, one does survive in the north, trying to eliminate this war factory, but it doesn't quite manage to, as the MiGs and the Gatling tanks finish the job, and those assault helicopters just not quite doing it. I guess helixes or something. Again, it's been a while. You'll have to bear with me. Another nuke firing off for Xcal. As just to the north, he finishes up this supply area, eliminating everything that the first nuke left in its wake. ECM, assault troop transport, and a listening outpost, but where is Xcal's response? It's going to be MiGs and Gatlings, which will be able to eat up the ECM tank quite quickly. Can the listening outpost do any real damage, though? The answer is no. One Gatling goes down, the other two survive, and the MiGs get even more kills. As an assault troop transport claims a couple of MiGs, but the Firestorm claims almost all of the minigunners. Three of them do survive, which may be enough to actually do some serious damage. Four of them actually survive. And they may actually be able to sneak into the back of Xcal's base and do some good damage. One MiG down, two, three MiGs eliminated. And those minigunners just shoot so incredibly rapidly against the very low health units that Xcal has grounded on that airfield. Once again, the MiGs coming through for Xcal. His units just kind of failing him as he doesn't have, I don't know, enough units to respond to all of the different areas or something. Either he's not realizing all of the locations that Hockey is trying to attack, or he just doesn't have enough units to respond to them. It seems like these two Gatling tanks are trying to pull double duty in both the north and the southern halves of the map to just run defense for everything Xcal has. He's got the nukes, but he doesn't have a lot of ground army to back it up. He's got two Battlemasters flanking this artillery platform, which Hockey captured a minute earlier in this game, and great carpet bombing directly on top of the War Factory cleans that up. An additional War Factory going to be going down for Hockey. He's going to be rebuilding after that, and it looks like artillery going to be getting called down potentially directly on top of this War Factory as Xcal looking to shut that down. And honestly, cleaning up the MiGs might be like the best bet for Xcal. I'm not sure what his total plan is there. He hits the airfield. He eliminates the airfield, but of course the MiGs were already in the sky. Launches another nuclear missile. Oh, I totally missed that one. Yeah, I don't even know. Another airfield in the north for Hockey. Fires off an artillery barrage and going to be hitting an airfield potentially. Yeah, cleans up the airfield of Xcal, but Xcal didn't actually have any MiGs on that particular airfield. They're all way up here in the north. Artillery barrage after artillery barrage for both of these guys. Hockey low on cash, but he's still got pretty steady income from all of his hackers, which he has spread out throughout the map. He's got all of these little groups of hackers. Very well done, and I know that this is, you know, standard practice for high-level players, but as a kid growing up, I just had, like, one group of hackers that were all grouped together because, of course, I was terrible at the game. But Black Lotus for Xcal, running some sneaky ops behind the scenes, going to be revealing the $6 that these guys are generating. Actually, just one of those guys. The other one just standing there doing nothing. Long distance resource collection as this dragon tank shuts down Hockey's resource trucks. They're not going to be able to do what they were designed to do. MiGs once again striking. Oh my gosh, this airfield going to be potentially shut down while the MiGs are on it, which is potentially a big loss. He does lose the MiGs, but Black Lotus gets eliminated, forced to rebuild the airfield almost right next to where it originally was. Black Lotus being killed off is certainly nice for Xcal, or for Hockey, as eliminating that threat from Xcal is always useful. The Dragon Tank trying to get forward, but it won't make it past the barracks. The Gatling Tank as well gets eliminated. And I guess another carpet bombing coming in, aimed directly at this airfield. Going to be able to clean that up, no problem. And this is almost just a war of attrition at this point. The ECM tank able to shut down the Gatling, but not able to shut down the MiGs as the listening outpost responds. And Hockey feels like he is just being beaten back slowly but surely. He was keeping up a lively assault when the nukes first started going off. But since then, it has not been as lively. He has been really struggling to get out onto Xcal's side of the map. And another Black Lotus heading out for Xcal, going to be crossing the bridge, causing all kinds of problems with the supply lines. As Xcal running another Black Lotus to try and finish this game out. This China Mirror, which started with that double War Factory versus the airfield play. And I mean, really, it's just turned into MiGs are awesome the game, as both of these guys doing just a ton of damage with MiGs. Carpet Bomber getting cleaned up, and Hockey will not be able to successfully make his run with that Carpet Bomber against Xcal. Another nuke ready to go. This nuclear trio that they've got going on that Xcal has is just pretty brutal, as the time delay between them is... It feels like there's constantly one going off, and there just about is. Lovely mine drop directly outside of that War Factory. And I think that was probably another airfield getting nuked, as that was the location of the rebuilt airfield. And just trying to nuke airfield after airfield. Talk about using a hammer to accomplish a small task. Airfield's having like 2 HP and getting just a full nuke for themselves. Black Lotus going to be revealing all of these hackers, going to be showing their locations. And I mean, really, I assume he's going for the command center, but there may actually be nothing that Hawkey can do about this in time. Black Lotus, oh, the dozer does step out just at the right or the wrong time, as Black Lotus is going to be forcing the sale of that command center. Goodbye, command center, as MiGs run operations to eliminate these hackers one after the other. I assume she was going to shut down that dozer, and it looks like that is indeed what is going to happen. Stopped at 17%. As unfortunately for Hawkey, he's going to have a hard time rebuilding that command center. Another Dragon Tank for X-Cal gets eliminated. A couple of rocket squads or a couple of tank hunters and an ECM going to be able to eliminate that Dragon Tank. Cancels the command center, builds another one. Potentially just going to be forcing Black Lotus to capture or force the sell-off of another command center in a minute or two. Battlemaster step forward. They are going to be supporting a couple of dragon tanks. And Hawkey, I don't know how he's going to pull this one off. If he has a chance of taking this, I'm not sure what he's going to be doing. But double command center, the play to conquer Black Lotus is to use the double command center carpet bomb, as he fires off a carpet bomb, and Hawkey is going to be getting a nuclear missile in response. So that is exactly what's going to be, well, I guess shutting down the dozer, that airfield, and doing a serious amount of damage to that command center. Not going to be enough to finish it off, but going to be enough to do some nice damage. Couple of Battlemasters with these Dragon Tanks still trying to make something happen, trying to do some kind of damage, but this Tank Hunter is actually doing some serious damage to shut them down. EMP completely whiffs. Of course, it was quite late for those Dragon Tanks and those Battlemasters as they had left the area. And X-Cal feeling absolutely in control for the last 5-10 minutes of this game, but unable to finish it off. And he's running what attacks he can, but a Black Lotus slips out for Hawkey. And Hawkey, this is his comeback chance. I'm not sure how he's going to win a war other than sneaky Black Lotus or some kind of tactic. I mean, he's had the income coming in for quite some time. All of the hackers spread throughout the map, but they're starting to get eliminated. They're starting to get cut down. And with all of the actual income around the map being gone for quite some time now, those hackers become more and more valuable over time. Dragon Tank crosses the bridge in the north, and Black Lotus just watches it happen. A couple of minigunners and a couple of tank hunters may actually be enough to just catch that Dragon Tank and shut it down quite easily without too much trouble. Another mine drop on top of this barracks instead of on top of the war factory. Well, goodbye barracks. It gets eliminated one way or the other, as another command post or a command center being forced to sell off, but another dozer did manage to get out just in time. And now this Gatling cannon or this Gatling tank Black Lotus combo is absolutely great. One airfield gets completely sold off there. I don't know if any MiGs were on that. That could have been all of the MiGs, and actually going to be a para drop. So Hawkey going to be dropping forces behind enemy lines to either capture or destroy this command center. But his Black Lotus is going to have to contend with these nukes, as she is just outside of the 3-nuke area. And what in the world is either player even going to do? Is Hawkey going to try and win this with like a Black Lotus just capturing everything one after the other? Is this Gatling tank takes forever to respond, but the Black Lotus, no, it's actually 2 Gatling tanks, so there's no way that she's shutting down both of them. I thought the stealth, okay, I was like, I thought she got stealth revealed when she was doing stuff, but there we go, it actually does happen. The Gatling's eliminate it. eliminate her, and the one nuclear missile is all that remains from Xcal's impressive armory previously. His impressive armaments from earlier in this game are considerably less impressive at this point. But Hawkey has definitely bought himself some a nice amount of time. Xcal with $5,000 in the bank, but apparently no way to spend it. I think he losing those airfields, cutting down his MiG production, and I guess his war factory. Does he just have the one war factory? He's not pumping anything out of the barracks. He does have a second war factory down here, so he's got production facilities to spend that cash, and he finally is spending it. Artillery barrage completely whiffs. Nothing actually there to be cleaned up. And Black Lotus may have been eliminated. I may have missed that, but Black Lotus might have gone down. Again, these artillery platforms actually being a bigger deal in this game than I would have anticipated. The MiGs, the artillery platform, and the Dragon Tank coming together to eliminate that little group of forces from Hawkey. Hawkey loses the listening outpost and the assault troop transport, so unfortunately for him. Another listening outpost may be going down, but no, it does clean up the Gatling tank and now closes the distance on the artillery platform inside of the minimum range to fire of that artillery platform. So that artillery platform is just dead. And with only one nuclear missile, this suddenly feels a lot less threatening, since in Zero Hour bases are so spread out anyways, just as a function of how people play the game. Everything is so spread out. You don't have super densely packed bases most of the time. And I guess this is Hawkey's Black Lotus steps out there onto the map. And all of these mines not being a good thing for Xcal, or for Hawkey rather, as Xcal drops the mines. But also carpet bombs, another airfield. A Helix steps out and going to be, well, killing a Dragon Tank before getting eliminated there. As these two guys just hammering each other time after time, but all of these small assaults, nothing with enough power to really end the game from either player. Hawkey for the last little while really just in survival mode, pulling off a couple of good moves to be able to keep himself in the game. Dragon Tank going to be joining up with the Black Lotus of Xcal to, I assume, kill the Black Lotus of Hawkey, but Hawkey may actually get the shutdown. No, he's going to be going for the capture of the artillery platform, which won't really do all that much. Are these MiGs going to just kill Black Lotus? They do get the kill on Black Lotus. The Tank Hunters get the kill on the Gatling, and these MiGs get the kill on, I guess, a couple of Tank Hunters, but not all that much. Black Lotus recaptures that artillery platform, and these two guys fighting as much over the artillery platforms as they are fighting over anything else in this game. Another Dragon Tank gets eliminated. The listening outpost barely goes down, and the Dragon Tank does fall at the last second there. I thought the Dragon Tank was going to die a little bit more quickly than that. Black Lotus getting revealed as Xcal escapes once again with his Black Lotus. Three Battlemasters, two Gatlings, and, well, nope, never mind. Black Lotus ditches that little group of forces, says, sayonara, I will see you later, and you guys can dine in hell or something like that. And the Gatling tank actually survives the Tank Hunters. I thought for sure those Tank Hunters, you know, one or two Tank Hunters eliminates, like, a couple hundred tanks. And EMP locks down four of these vehicles. The Gatling tank with the double vet, the only one that survives, going to be hunting a couple of MiGs as it cleans up two MiGs, almost gets a third, but everything else still unpowered as Black Lotus, I think, getting eliminated once again. Xcal unable to keep Black Lotus alive for too much longer. Another carpet bombing going to be coming in as the MiGs strike out against the forces of Xcal. Another war factory, another dozer getting eliminated, and I don't even know that it was the MiGs. I thought it was the MiGs cleaning up this group of Battlemasters, but it was Tank Hunters, Lysian Outpost, and an ECM joining together.
And the MiGs don't actually eliminate anything. There's enough health in these units to survive, and the artillery platform missing a couple of shots, which means everything survives for the current moment. The listening outpost and the ECM barely making it through that. Will they be able to clean up the dragon tank before the dragon tank finishes them off? And it looks like the answer is yes. The dragon tank gets shut down, but barely eliminates the listening outpost. The fully heroic tank hunter does survive from inside of the listening outpost. He does make it to the outside. And finally, another nuke does go off, as in the north, it eliminates the airfield. And I think that was really the only thing it got there. Maybe a little bit of damage on the command center and a little bit of damage on the barracks. I guess anything that steps out will get irradiated and die, but other than that, artillery once again going to be firing off for X-Cal. I guess he's going for either the war factory or going to try and eliminate the barracks. I don't know what he's firing at. Other war factory? Yeah. He cleans up the other war factory. But there's a replacement war factory going to be coming out for Hockey. MiGs for X-Cal, cleaning up Hockey's forces. And once again, Hockey barely holding on, just constantly surviving by the thinnest thread possible. X-Cal feeling impossible to close this out. It's just like it feels like we're going to be here forever. This game is going to never end as these small skirmishes happen again and again. And it's basically the same set of units going against the same set of units with, by and large, the same result. As soon as someone makes a little bit of headway towards their opponent, they get eliminated by MiGs. Wouldn't it be great if Black Lotus could hack MiGs in the sky? Just crashes to the ground, gets eliminated. Going to be running right past a dragon tank, but of course no stealth reveal, so Black Lotus escapes for now. Carpet bombing and the MiGs going to be able to clean up, and going to be a cluster bomb, cluster mine, directly on top of the barracks. So too bad Black Lotus is already out on the map doing her thing. Another Black Lotus from X-Cal, as these two guys are, well, looking to do something. This is a lot of cash coming from this internet center. And Black Lotus bypasses it. X-Cal going to be able to keep that for now. The nuclear missile, 3.5 minutes. But no, that also isn't the target for Hockey, as he is looking to go somewhere else with that Black Lotus. And X-Cal revealing just how many hackers Hockey has in this little quadrant of the map. Even more of them over here that he doesn't quite see just yet. Artillery firing off, going to be targeting the airfield once again. Gets eliminated. Hockey dropping infantry again, going to be able to kill a dozer in the middle of building a command center. Although the listening outpost is here, it is not enough to stop to keep the dozer alive. The MiGs and the Gatling going to be able to finish off the minigunners. No, the minigunner barely survives. He kills everything. That heroic minigunner eliminates everything. And if that was X-Cal's last dozer and last command center, then that may actually be significant. But there is a dozer in the north rebuilding an airfield. Airstrike after airstrike, artillery barrage after artillery barrage. And there are just infinite numbers of airfields to be built in this game. Assault troop transport going to be eliminating, I think, Black Lotus or something inside of that hut, and everything gets eliminated. Tries to capture the power plant. It looks like the power plant got sold off one way or the other. It's not enough to send X-Cal into low power mode, as his nuclear missile still ticking away there as this game ticks past like the 40-minute mark. Finally, this Gatling tank does indeed clean up that minigunner. And Hockey with a kind of scary force. 3 listening outposts, an assault troop transport, and an ECM tank. The phase of the game where that is scary is in the beginning, in the middle, and at the end. So we're in that phase of the game. Mines, will they actually clip anything? The assault troop transport driving right into them, and despite the stealth reveal, he does drive into it a little bit. He does get healed up, though, so no big loss either way. artillery platform getting a good shot off, and Hockey is going to be stepping forward. Carpet bombs X-Cal's War Factory and may actually be able to catch these Battlemasters a little bit out of position, a little bit unawares. The ECM locks down a Gatling for a moment before it gets eliminated, which gives enough time for the rest of these minigunners and listening outposts to clean up the rest of X-Cal's army. And suddenly, X-Cal doesn't have very much to respond with. He's got not much cash in the bank either, as I guess his internet cafe is not producing quite as much as he would like. I think overall, Hockey has had more hackers and for longer at this point in the game. The MiGs clean up a couple of the minigunners, but the rocket troopers are enough to eliminate that War Factory. Goodbye, War Factory. And this command center in the north from Hockey is, I guess, a manor command center on the left side of the map, as X-Cal GG's out of that game. I think he had just literally no units left after he lost that entire army there to Hockey's forces. And Hockey, with the slow grind, the war of attrition, just burying X-Cal, even though for 25 minutes of that game, it felt like X-Cal was the one with the better trades, the more consistency. And I mean, those three nukes time and time again, but it was not enough. And in the end, Hockey takes it. That will do it for this action-packed China kind of mirror. Thank you all very much for watching. If there's a way to eliminate like half of the text from Gentool, I would love to know that, because I don't need all of this. I just need those nameplates on the side with the money. Actually, I really just need the money. I just need to know. Anyways, thank you all very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it, and this is Cybert signing out.